Now then, let's go this way. This is Lawn on Ramp. These guys, I don't know their official name, but they're giant moles, and if you let them attack you, they will come out of the ground and form a giant stack like this. Watch. And then you can just do that and just murder them all. It's wonderful. These enemies aren't much of a big deal right now. In the bottom right, as I was saying before, you can see we have our rupee count. And in the top left, we have our hearts. Top right will show us what items we have equipped. In the bottom left, just absolutely frigging nothing. It's pretty great. So, anyway, I know the way to Minish Woods. If you are following along, just follow the route that I'm taking. You don't have to kill all the enemies. I just prefer to do that. These little things, we can't pass them right now, but I'm sure we will get something to get those eventually. Get something to get those. Wonderful. So, we're just moving along. There's not really any point to cutting these down right now. But there will be eventually. Oh, I'm so used to an attack that I have later. But yeah, rolling is one of the best ways to get around, basically. These things are green choo-choos. That explains something. If you go into water, well, not this kind of water. This is shallow water. But if you go into that big water, you will kind of just flail around. Let's kill that green choo-choo right there. Right here we have a stomp. Nothing really big about that. At least not yet. Anyway. So we go up here. I believe it is we have to go up here.
Help me!
Oh dear.
Ouch! Won't somebody stop them? Ow! Help! Somebody! Can anybody hear me?
Oh dear, we better help that guy out. That's horrible. Anyway, let's go up, and we saw him being attacked by some Octorox before. So.
Hey kid, you there! Ow! Hey, don't just stand there! Do something! Ow! What's wrong with you? You like watching me take this abuse? Help me!
So let's just kill these guys. No big deal.
Phew! Well done! That was close! Not that I couldn't handle that myself. But that's beside the point. What in the world is a lone child doing deep in the woods? Oh, I see. The Picori, you say? And Vati? Vati's curse, someone? What? The Sacred Blade? The Sacred Blade. The Sacred Blade. Is that so? I see. You know, you and I have quite a lot in common. You see, I, too, am on a quest to break a curse of Vati's. And you say that reforging the Sacred Blade can break his curse, eh? Well, then you have found yourself a companion, my boy. My name is Ezlo. It's a pleasure to meet you.
I'm just gonna...
Wait, I say! You walk so quickly! Too quickly, in fact! Can't you go any slower? Surely you've noticed that I have no legs.
Okay, fine, I'll go slower for you.
Boy, take a good look at me! Do you really think I can walk that fast? Actually, yes! You just were! If it isn't one thing, it's another! You're a troublesome boy! There! Now you can't possibly leave me behind! My, it's quite comfortable up here. More comfortable than it looks, surely. And much easier on me. Hey, quit your squirming! Can't you sit still? See? There. Yes, that's it. Much better. Now, I suppose a boy like you still has much to learn about the world. If you ever need my insight, press select! I'll be happy to help. Ah, such a hopeless child. So we can press select. What? I haven't even had time to settle in, and you're bothering me? You would shrine lies, obviously enough, deep in the heart of the woods. So, says my superior intuitive sense. Oh, because I couldn't figure that out on my own. Hold on for a moment, my boy. We stumbled across something important. The world of the Minish is very small. You're far too big to meet them now. Eh? Who are the Minish? Ah, yes, silly me. Allow me to explain. You humans call them Picori, but they refer to themselves as the Minish. Strange how, in the world of humans, only this forest has kept that name. Anywho, deep in the forest, they've built a tiny village, where many now live. But if we're to enter the village, I have to make you a touch smaller first. Look at that! At first glance, it appears to be a mere stump, yes? No, that stump is a portal used by the people long ago to adjust their size. With my help, you can use it to shrink down to Minish size. Just stand on the stump and press R to shrink. To return to normal, stand next to the stump and press R. Get me up there and we'll give it a try. Now, stumps are the only things that can shrink you. And, by the way, I can't skip this. After the first time, for most shrinkings, you can skip them. There are a few exceptions, though. And as we can see, we're shrinking down to only a few pixels big. But we look so cool! I love this game just for the shrinking, that whole thing. It's a cool gimmick, and I love it. Welcome to the world through the eyes of the Minish. Now, aren't you glad you saved me? No need to thank me, though. What does that reduce your size are all around in different shapes and sizes. If you want to return to normal, stand next to a portal and press R. But there is one thing you must know. Being Minish sized is full of dangers. Near puddles at your normal size are bottomless swamps of the Minish. And as your companion, if anything bad happens to you, it happens to me too. So proceed with caution, my lad. If not for your sake, then for my own. Anyway, as roll is also R, if you can't roll in the logs, by the way. Since roll is also R, you can't really roll when we're next to a portal. Also, something that I should show off is that, yes, these do act as big pools of water when you are Minish size. Also, I love the animations. It's so hilarious. I love everything about this game. This game is amazing. Also, you can use your sword, but everything else, and there will be other things. Everything else, when you're big and when you're in a normal hub as a Minish sized person, you can't use any of it. This is the Minish Village. Now then. It appears we have found the Minish Village. Oh boy.
Pico, Picori! Ribi, Ribico, Picori! Picoco, Pico, Ribico!
I gather it's been quite some time since they last saw a human. What's that? You didn't understand what they were saying just now? Ah yes, that was the language of the Minish. It's a little different from the dialect that I'm most familiar with. I'm afraid I didn't catch most of what they said myself. But perhaps there's someone who understands your language. We should look around. Now, these people will all say things that are kind of useless, so just don't worry about them for now. What we need is we need to go up here.
I've never seen an outfit like that before. Are you a human?
Oh my, it's been quite some time since any humans came here. My name is Festari. I watch the Abbey as well as the shrine to the north. You seem to be having some trouble with our language, don't you? You can use a javanut. It will allow you to understand our tongue. You should be able to find one in the barrel house just south of here. And that's exactly what we'll do. Now, I'll get into this hub later, but for now, all we need to understand is where we're going. Now then, you come down here, and you can push these things. Like that. This thing right here.
Oh, Carvin! This must be the javanut Festari told you about! Well, you'd better eat it if you plan on making any progress at all!
You ate the javanut! Now you can understand the language of the Minish! Like, watch here. So you've eaten the javanut, and now you can understand us! The Elder said that the humans can no longer see us like they once could. It's amazing that you can see us. Well, I guess. So, what we need to do now is that most of this village is useless for now. This is moderately useful in the future. Although, it's not too useful. Oh, you speak our language. It's been quite a while since we've heard outsiders speak our tongue. We have little to offer you in these woods, but please enjoy your stay.
Leave your offer. We have no time to relax. My name is Eslo. This child is Kevin. need to take a break. We need to break a curse. Not take a break to the curse, but we need to break it.
And it has been cast on the Princess of Hyrule.
To do so, we need to reforge this broken Picori blade.
Ah, yes, and you've come here now to have this blade reforged. If you want the blade reforged, you'll need the four elements. These are the crystalline forms. Only by infusing the blade with these energies can a new blade be forged. Here, give me your map. I can mark where these elements can be found. Interesting. Very interesting. The earth element can be found at the shrine to the north of Festari's Abbey. Speak with Festari, he will show you the path to the shrine's entrance. But with caution, evil creatures have lately made their home into our shrine. Return to me at once after you have found the earth element.
So we'll do just that!
Anyway, actually, I was thinking I'll do the first dungeon, then I'll end off this recording session, because I have other things I want to record, and I have stuff that I want to do.
You wish to go to the shrine? Very well, this way.
Wild beasts have settled in recently. Be careful, it's quite dangerous. Now, we go through here, and as you can see, we can't really get this right now. Actually, if I had gone all the way this way before, I could have gotten that. But, you know, I forgot that was there a little bit. Hindsight is only 20/20. To the left and the right, it just takes you out of the shrine, just like going to the bottom. Anyway, this is our first dungeon.
So this would be the Deepwood Shrine the Minish Elder spoke of.
He said something about there being monsters inside, didn't he?
Hey now!
No reason to be afraid or anything, I'll be waiting right here.
No wait, what am I saying? I'm not letting you leave me alone out here.
There are 6 dungeons in this game. Maybe 7, depending on what you consider a dungeon. But this is the first of which. Now, most of the dungeons will have a... most of the dungeons will have a element at the end. Although there are some exceptions. As you can see, there are only 4 elements, so not all of them could possibly have elements in them. This is a key. Now you just open...
There's a locked door here. See if you can find a key to open it.
We did! Come on. Now you can just press R next to the doors, and that'll open the doors. These enemies, if you get them before they're on their belly, you can one-shot them. Anyway, I can explain this better, but if you pull those all the way back, some cool stuff can happen. You can also pull these mushrooms will launch us! Whee! Anyway, so, as we make our way through the dungeon, now, the map functions differently in the dungeon than it does on the overworld. On the overworld, it gives you a view of the entire world. Well, for the most part, there are areas that you haven't explored yet, which won't be on the map, but for the most part, it gives you a full view of the world. Now, in dungeons, it'll give you a view of the dungeon, of course, and that's very helpful. Now then, what we need to do is we need to burn that, and that'll free it from this. Now, that's important in a little bit here. Those things are called pustules. They will make little thingamajiggers. Anyway, we go through here, and we can't get rid of that dirt yet, but we will eventually. So, as we can see, one of these doesn't work. So, we need to have them both right at the same time, so we'll just move that statue, and bingo! So, now, there's nothing holding this back. So, we can go in here, and we can do cool stuff. Hey, careful, the thing just moved. So now, if I can get this just, there we go. Okay, I believe this is the first area we need to go to. These things are called, oh dear, I don't remember. I know their name if I saw it, but I can't remember off the top of my head. Now then, it tells you what exactly kind of pressure you need to get over that. If you do it too much, you will fall into that lake. However, what it doesn't tell you is that if you do it all the way, like I will show here, if you do it all the way, you go over here. There's a big chest, and it's got a dungeon map. Now, what that does is that it will show us rooms. Rooms that we haven't been in are shaded
rooms that we have been in are a lighter shade of purple. As you can see, there's a lot to this dungeon. It's fairly big for a Zelda first dungeon. That's because there's not as many dungeons in this game. As I stated before, there's only 6, where in a normal Zelda game would have 9. But that's not to say that this is a short game, really. Now then, how might we solve this puzzle, you may ask? Well, the solution is quite simple. We just, as you can see, it's got push marks right there that tells us to push.
Push, 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 push!
So, now this room is quite interesting. Now, as we've shown, we can push it by just moving onto it. We can pull objects like that. Now then, what we need to do is, because these both are pressure switches, we need to do that, and that gives us a small key. Now then, that's the end of this path. Now, what we need to do, now that we've done that, we can go down here, go over here, go through here, up here, and now we need to start, I believe there's one if we go up. Yes, there is. Whoopsie. Yep, there we go. Now then, we can do that if we want, but it doesn't really make much of a difference. For now, we're going through this door. Now, there is a limit to how many rupees that you can have. I forgot to mention this. But there is a limit to how many rupees you can have. Right now, I believe it's a maximum of 100 rupees. Eventually, we'll get upgrades, and that'll... Whoa! Forgot that you only pull that back a certain way. That's what that skid mark was supposed to represent. But oh well. Now then. We gotta pull this back here. And that'll put us over here. Now then. This room is another interesting room, and I like how it's designed. Because you can see that we can't really get to that switch normally. But what we have to do is we have to pull this over here, one past the switch at least. You can do it more if you want, but we need one past the switch because we need to get this one on the switch. See? It's cool. It's a cool little room. Now then, this is a enemy kill all the enemies room. Now, sometimes killing all the enemies on a map will give you a certain thing or have a certain event happen. But in this case, it gives you a key, which is cool. Now we're back up here. Excuse me if I get some things wrong. I haven't played through this game much. I've only done... This is my 3rd playthrough. So I will miss a few things at first. Please bear with me. Now then, I believe we go over here. Because we can't go down quite yet. It doesn't do anything. These enemies are invincible. For now, anyway. For now, they're invincible. Now then, we go in here. There is our first mini-boss. Now, this thing is fairly simple. Hit its head and then slash at its tail. It's fairly simple. It doesn't have a set path, so it can be fairly troubling. And the mini-bosses are different from bosses, and they occur different places besides just in a single dungeon. This boss, especially, the mini-boss, rather. This mini-boss occurs several times in the game, so get used to fighting it. Okay, now then, here is